Hello everyone, welcome once again. Myself Jyoti Tiwari and I am teaching you chapter Reproduction in Organism. Here I am going to discuss about grafting, layering, cutting. I have already told you what is grafting, layering and cutting, but there are several definitions. I think that student may get confused about these definitions. These definitions are actually types of grafting, layering and cutting. So grafting may be of different kinds: whip grafting, tongue grafting, wedge grafting, crown grafting. So what are the difference between these type of grafting? Only there is a difference of cutting, that in which manner you are cutting the shoot. Okay, in which manner you are cutting the shoot. If you are cutting the shoot in this manner, okay, in this manner, then it is called whip grafting. If you are cutting it in this manner, this is called tongue grafting. Okay, and in wedge grafting, you are taking thickness, equal thickness of both the shoot, and if cut it like a tongue like manner, it is called wedge grafting. Crown grafting, you take the stem in this manner like a crown, and in upper region you take another shoot like this. This is called crown. It is crown grafting. You are taking shoot. The lower portion is called stalk and the upper portion is called scion. Okay, so stalk has root portion also. Layering. Now discuss what is layering. Layering can be of different type. Tip layering, I have told you that we have taken what? Branches. If you pull the tip of branch inside the underground root, it is called tip layering. If you take any, it was the plant, no? If you take any stem in the lower region, it is called continuous. Continuous layering means the whole branch is inside or underground the soil. It is called continuous layering. None of portion is outside the soil. It is whole in underground region. Okay. Compound layering is such type in which you have taken the plant and its branch in like this manner. Okay, whole above and little bit inner, above and little bit inside of the soil. So the branches is like in this type of manner, little bit outside in the atmospheric region and little bit in the inside underground region, and from there new plant arise. Okay, so these are type of layering. Air layering occur in such type of trees whose branches can't be pulled down inside the earth in underground. Okay, so you can remove the outer covering of branch and tie it, and after some time you observe that new plant arises from that branch. You are actually removing here outer layer of the branch only. Okay, so that it get new exposed to atmospheric region, and air can interact with the exposed region, and a new plant can grow from here. Cutting which require leaf means if you are taking a twig part which have leaf portion also, like herbaceous cutting, okay, and soft shoot, it is of cutting which require leaf. It is a type. Cutting which do not require leaf means you are taking here cutting of hard wood. So such type of example come in cutting. Now next is micropropagation. What is micropropagation? In this type of process, generally we take few cells and we prepare a nutrient medium. Okay, nutrient medium. This medium has all the nutrients which are essential for plant growth, like nitrogen is there, carbon is there, okay, there is sucrose, okay, there is sucrose, and everything which is necessary for plant growth is present in this nutrient medium. And we put here few cells of the plant. After some days, you observe that the cells are growing in a group form. This group is called callus. In this callus, you will later observe that there is formation of shoot. Okay, so these shoots can be taken out and can be put in different medium which has nutrient in different amount. Okay, because you know na, you in childhood the nutrient requirement is little bit different, and when you become adult your nutrient requirement will become different. So there is change of medium, and when you change the medium and put the shoot after taking out from this medium, here there is formation of root takes place. After little bit growth, we grow such plant in nursery. So that in huge amount we can grow large amount of plant of desired character of our benefit. Okay, so this is micro propagation. I will meet you in next lecture video with next topic. Thank you so much. If you like the video, please do the like. Okay, thank you so much. Have a good day.